Now here's a few of the few more useful tips you might find from your settings menu on your screen. Some of the things you might come across on a day-to-day basis. If I come to my apps section, I'm going to be looking for my cog for my settings. By tapping on this, this will take me through to the settings page on my screen here. Now obviously all of the settings that you have on here can be managed remotely via your MDM if you've enrolled the screen into your free Clevertouch MDM software package. But just a few of the things that you might find useful in this space. Up the top here, I have my Wi-Fi buttons under wireless and networks. Tapping into my Wi-Fi option at the top here, this will show me all of my available Wi-Fi networks. If I'm not receiving a signal to my board, I just need to make sure that my Wi-Fi is turned on at the top. And then obviously I can tap on my network and enter the password to get my Wi-Fi signal directly to the screen itself. Using my back arrow takes me out to my main settings menu here. Users over here under personal. This is where it would give you the option to tailor the users that you have on the screen. So if you wanted to add a pupil user with safer, more tied down application features and available features to your pupils, then this is where you would do that. Likewise, this is where you'd have the option to change the names of your users and tailor some of those features such as passwords, etc. Using my back arrow will take me out here. I have under here, again under personal, I have startup and shutdown. This will allow me really to tailor the screen in terms of what files are kept on the screen and what files are removed whenever I start or shut the screen down. Down the bottom here, I have my ability to add timers for a boot start time and a turn off time. Really useful if you're in a school and you want your screens to be turned on automatically in the morning and turn off automatically at lunchtime or at the end of the day. And again, you can schedule those with a number of times. If you wanted to add more than one time, you can do that. Really useful for this section here is what files are removed automatically when the Clevertouch screen is shut down. So again, you can see over here, we've got the option to remove our cloud accounts, our email accounts, etc. So they would also be automatically removed when the screen is shut down. Likewise, they would also be the files that are removed when you use your floating pen menu and bin icon to leave meeting. That would remove those files from your screen as well. So nice and safe and secure. And obviously as an educational institution, you've got a safety net of having a shutdown boot time at the end of the day to remove any files if you need to do that. Coming back to my settings menu here, one other thing you might find useful is coming to about device. So if I tap on about device, this just gives me the few more details about the screen itself. But crucially, in the top right hand corner, I've got the option to check for updates. So by tapping on check for updates, you can find out if your firmware is up to date or if you have any free over-the-air updates that you need to install for your Clevertouch Impact or Impact Plus.